Yo, sup everybody, it's my geese here, and today I am going to react, as you can see on my screen, to the Wolverine Waves version 1.3 Black Shores broadcast, aka the WUA 1.3 live stream. We're gonna see what they're gonna have to offer for 1.3. I'm excited for this, bro. I could tell that 1.3 is already looking good. It's gonna have a lot of shit going on. Let's see how much grander they make it, cause you know, 1.2, bro. That shit was kind of a dead patch. But let's see if they do something insane with 1.3. Anyways, I'm gonna skip the beginning. I got the luxury of not watching the live stream live, so I could just skip that shit. Shorekeeper crossplay. Ooh, that's cool. Let's see what they doing. Hey, what a start. They must be playing new music. That's gonna be in the next version. Probably. Okay. Pretty cool. It gotta be for new music for the new area though. 100%. 1,000,000,000%. Okay. I see them. This shows that this next patch is gonna be a big patch. I'm happy for it. It seems to be doing bigger things with it. Donk. Donk. I forgot this nigga's name was Dong. Man, he's so young, bro. The game design, he is such a young dude. His name's Dong. Okay, that's enough.
Alright.
We'll be co-hosted. Let's see.
Hello, Wen.
What's up, Ho? Damn, these niggas are young. Holy shit. God damn. Okay. Oh my god.
I'm fucking this music.
不过不用担心啊，月有阴晴圆缺，分离与相伴而生。没错，所以呢，在即将到来的新版本当中，我们将暂别荆州，跟随着这艘巴掌，踏上了一座陌生而又熟悉的故事。Nice，can't wait for us to get into the drop that a black shores.
若是得到许可啊，一般人可无法踏足哦。I like that shit. Camellia, damn, bro.
I can't wait to see her coming, bro. Cause goddamn.
Shit.村，甚至啊，有一些漂泊者已经发现了，在之前的故事当中，有一只一直神秘跟随着我们主角的蝴蝶。那么，这只神秘蝴蝶它究竟代表着什么呢？终于，在接下来的1.3版本当中，我们就要亲身踏上
黑暗的神秘岛屿了。嗯，没错，在这个版本中，漂泊者们不仅可以了解黑暗。 更可以探寻自身失去的部分记忆，还能够追寻这些记忆的原因，窥见自身来处秘密的一角。看来主线的信息很密集呢，百闻不如一见。给大家播放一下我们的先行展示视频吧。Oh,
the version 1.3 trailer, nice, nice. Let's see. The lament. The earthrend assembly. Lament. Okay. Let me chill. The more steps we take, the closer we draw to the inevitable destruction. But this time, I will bring everything to a proper end. For everything you've done. Goodbye. the shore's end. This is insane looking.
Humans dream to fulfill their desires.
They go shorekeeper.
For a long time, I believed such dreams were
she look good. For me. She's so elegant. She remind me a lot of Azura from Fire Emblem Fates. If you guys don't know who that is, look her up. She really reminds me a lot of her.
Awaiting their fated journey.
Huh. Oh, she's British. Shorekeeper is British. Get old parties, bottles of water. I'm a So this girl has QTE, like quick time events mechanics. She's the Yoo-hoo!
That leads to the deepest parts of the woolly.
Yoo-hoo!
Only those who believe in the kingdom. All right. Individual sacrifices
are inconsequential. That's the new boss that they showed on the site.
We are forever trapped on the event horizon of the black hole, falling into an unending darkness.
It's from the moon. Uh-oh, encore. I see.
Civilizations. Nothing can escape it. It sounds the death knell for humanity. The lament.
Get old bodies, but as a what?
和荆州有很大的不一样啊。
没错, 黑海岸本身拥有极为发达的科研技术,
bro, these, both these niggas think they auto.
其总体设计上会更偏向于现代科幻的感觉。 结合其海岛的设定啊, 我们对其美术进行了一次全新的设计, 希望能为大家呈现一个
really fucking good trailer, by the way. That shit was so good.
关于这座充满了未知的岛屿, 我们也为大家准备了一段视频, 让我们一起来了解一下吧。
They're showing off the different parts of the areas. Look how crisp that looks. Oh my goodness. It's not much to say right here, because they're just showing the area. It's just a little preview of what they're showing. It's not much for me to say. That's why I'm just calling it quiet. Oh, the black flowers. That'll be from Camellia.
除了孤独矗立在海上的黑石岛屿, 黑海岸的地表之下也另藏玄机哦。 这些谜题都在等待大家前往探索。 在黑海岸中，不仅有独特的回音植物、奇异的生物，随着技术的发展啊，黑海岸还诞生出了一些特别的移动方式呢。哦，那有哪些特别的移动方式呢？在黑海岸的地下中啊，漂泊者们可以通过传送门在多个隔绝的空间内实现无缝穿梭哦。那除此之外啊，还有一些其他的移动方式，让我们一起来看一下实际演示视频吧。
Okay, these are the puzzles that they're showing off. Okay, I see him. Oh shit. We got portals shooting lasers. Wow.
哦，这样我就可以穿过各种奇异的空间，前往黑暗的各个角落打卡了呢。
太爽了。
嗯，不过我看刚才的场景演示，黑暗的地下仿佛另外的一个空间，哎，它有一个很奇异的光柱，而且它的天空好像也是一幅很奇异的星图，不知道这些它有没有什么隐藏的信息呢？
其实黑暗地底下的秘密与我们全新的共鸣者紧密相连哦。在 1.3 版本中，随着
水晶主线的开放，全新四星公民者，okay, more the story.
以及全新四星公民者守岸人
，more the main story.
正式登场啦！当当当当，等这一刻等好久了，我们的新共鸣者终于要来了。
因缘际会，右狐将在这次的故事中与调查失忆线索的探索者以及泱泱在归墟岛市相遇。
那么关于右狐，我们有没有什么情报可以跟漂泊者们分享一下吗？
那右狐
，You who has QTE，
师承荆州的古物大师陈皮，个头虽小，本事可不小哦。他总是用轻松自得的神态来为来客辨别古物的好坏。身为穿行在黄龙各州的鉴宝大师，右狐的嘴皮子功夫绝对是一流的，打油诗张口就来，和倒卖损坏古物的坏蛋争辩时，也是头头是道，气势十足呢。
听起来是个个性十足的角色啊。哎，那它的设计是不是也一样有趣啊？
哎嘿，你说到重点了。我们围绕着右狐的角色性格，为它打造了一套趣味性较强的战斗机制，希望能为大家提供丰富的战斗反馈。右狐的战斗依靠它背后的小匣子进行，匣中是它利用自己的凝冰能力制造的古物道具，古物是它追寻的珍重之物，
还
用于走江湖的防身道具，也使用了它们的形态。而愿意尊重古物的人也会赢得右狐大师的好感与真诚，只不过呢，他不擅长战斗，还总喜欢虚张声势，在人面前摆弄三脚猫的功夫，看似自信满满，实则却满身破绽。
So she gotta be like a support or something, like a buffer.
他的战斗技能应该也跟古物脱不了很多干系吧？
是的，为了契合其个性，丰富角色玩法，我们为其战斗技能增加了。
I went for the showcase the QTE mechanic with Yuhu because I know that she's a 4-star and I know they're doing this QTE mechanic, this quick time event mechanic with her because I think with her it's more of a test, so they want to see if they can implement this with more characters. That's what I think this is with her.
当手中的匣子不慎脱手飞出时，大家就可以自由选择享用的道具了。
Yeah, that's the part.
在战斗中抽中大奖的反馈了，
战斗爽
爽。
随着事件的
This girl is RNG based. That's gonna be something.
异常频率，在上传到黑海岸最核心的终端系统泰提斯时，触发了他本就即将爆发的危机。而当漂泊者回到黑海岸，那个传说中只会在黑海岸出现危机时，才会为了帮助黑海岸真正领导者。而现身的守岸人出现在了众人眼前。
黑海
Shorekeeper, yeah, it makes sense, but we finally have a girl.
这个问题的答案
We finally getting the leader of the Black Shores.
去发掘了。那接下来还是由我来介绍一下关于这个神秘的守岸人的情报吧。
That's crazy.
其实
Because they're like, aren't they like the main enemies that we're dealing with right now?
黑海岸守护紧密相连的。
Kind of.
顾名思义，他拥有强大的。
Cause we got these guys in a tacit discord.
当角色受到致死伤害时，守岸人所拥有的特殊技能效果将提高角色生存的机会，提升队伍的容错率。另外，他的共鸣解放机制也将为队伍提供额外的伤害增益，比如提升暴击相关。所以说啊
，I figure she would be like more of a support. I think she'll be support. She
because
when Black Shore, when I first saw her, she was screaming 5-star support character. Because we haven't had one of those in a minute. I mean, Jet High is technically one, but.
守岸人是他本来的名字吗？这个名字感觉挺特别的。另外，守岸人他的形象好像也很神秘。比如说呢，其实我没有。
We haven't gotten a new healer, huh? In a minute.
你观察得很仔细嘛。守岸人的存在和名
字。I don't think she's a healer. I think she's a healer. I don't know.
有着紧密的联系。 结合他的故事设定和合
作的演出，
我们在他的技能上也有进行相应的设计，比如我们使用了类似数据频率的特效去呼应他的身份背景。我们也为守岸人设计了变身的机制，守岸人可以化身蝴蝶进入解线状态，在场景中进行快速的移动，并自动摘取沿路的植物。这是一个非常实用的日常机制哦。
She looks really good though.
考虑到她和漂浮者之间的密切联系，
I was gonna call her
我们也在她的智能设计中增加了一个针对漂浮者的特殊增益。
I fuck with her design heavy.
频率有变身的机制，还有针对漂泊者的特殊增益。哇，听起来她的战斗机制好丰富啊！不过我刚才在看她的一个设计的时候，我可以看到她身上其实有一些星空的元素，不知道这些元素代表什么。
Kinda does.
那当然是有特殊的。
Her design reminds me a lot of I'm gonna say this again. It reminds me a lot of Azura from Fates, from Problem Fates.
梦幻领域。
Has she healed?
天空会被复刻进领域中，在领域中的队友释放变奏技能后，领域的效果和表现将会得到进化。而在达到某种特定
的。Okay, so she don't heal. She's probably another sub DPS or something. She's probably like a off-field DPS or some shit.
当然随着角色更新，我们的武器也会有更新。这次版本呢，我们将上线全新的五星音感仪星绪写响，它的整体是以蝴蝶星云为设计主题。
Those weapons look cool.
其实也跟我们的星空
仪 The fire is hell.
整体呢，我们希望保持
She's another red the fire. Right, she should be a red the fire character.
星系列武器深空药变系列。
And they put some new 4-star weapons into the mix.
另外，完成我们的版本活动，也可以自选其中的一把哦。
那说了这么多，我们是不是该掏出一点亮晶晶的东西，让大家提起神了？
嘿嘿，
就是那个
来了。
Okay.
我们为大家准备了本次临时通讯的特别奖励。
You got the redemption code.
下方的兑换码就可获得奖励了哦。
Get that shit in right now, guys.
在截止时间前领取哦。那说完了新角色和新武器，东策划再来跟大家说大家比较关注的内容吧。
好，那么首先就是深海部分，超帅气的新深海即将登场。
More echoes, okay.
将面对了。
Are we gonna get like a new echo set? Like a new ability set?
无生命体也能成为深海。
That's gonna be awesome.
是的，这是漂泊者们遭遇的对手，他的名字叫做无龟的谬误。据我所知，他和
黑暗的泰
迪斯系统息息相关。
He could be a new win. He could probably be for the win set or a brand new set.
测量中枢兼具着文明推演的功能，是黑海岸运作的基石。你说的这个 boss 无龟的谬误，它到底强不强？
它不是那种强不强的问题，它是那种，我觉得多说无益，不如我们一起来看一看视频吧。
All right, all right, we're gonna have a trailer for the shit. Hey.Alright, this nigga, bruh. Damn, he's trying to smash your ass with that damn hammer. Damn! Bro is wild for that. Bro, oh, he splits his arms into two. Well, he forms extra arms and become Thanos with those...
无龟的谬误究竟
That's his echo ability? That's crazy.
那他为什么会和漂
泊者 That shit's fucking insane, bro. That looks fucking dope as hell.
到我们游戏里面的主线故事去亲自揭晓答案。除此之外 1.3 版本我们还将新增两个异象深海。
More phantom echoes, okay.
关心的红名特殊敌人这次也有
It is what it is. I wish they do more with the shiny echoes, you know what I'm saying?
两个挑战玩法
Like, make more of them, like,Make all the echoes have shining echoes from the start, then you just gotta like search for them. It's unfortunate that shining echoes always appear in the same spot.
In Overworld. 就会解锁我们的一些红名特殊敌人。这次我们增加了五个升级的特殊敌人。当然，我们的敌人升级了，我们的奖励也升级了。
Okay, more of those red bosses.
投放在宝箱里面，也就是说你要成功挑战了我们的特殊敌人之后。就可以一次性领取三个宝箱，我们的奖励会更加集中，也更方便你领取了。
哇，奖励爽！
另一个增加了长期挑战，就是我们的老朋友了，全息战略缭绕之旗。
Inferno Rider Hologram, this guy is gonna be something else because Inferno Rider is a very intriguing boss and fight because he flips between being on his little motorcycle, and then when you break your shit the first time, he gets off his motorcycle, which is fucking cool, bro. He's a very cool boss to fight. He's one of the fun bosses. Really fun.
演练数据集在我们的演练三天当中得到你所需要的奖励啦。
哦，真棒。不过说了这么多，好像还没跟大家介绍活动的相关情报。那接下来还是由东策划快和大家分享一下吧。
好嘞，在1.3版本呢，我们也为漂泊者们准备了丰富的活动，除了版本七日签到活动、战狼阵营之外，
nice.
我们还将在1.3版本推出一位共鸣者的。
Once again, all of those should be limited pulls. They still giving you standard pulls in a 10-day login.
版新任务：小小羊咩大冒险。
耶、yeah.。好诶，
在这个任务当中呢，我们将
Is this a parkour event? With encore?
童话般的羊咩王国，体验一段新奇的冒险。
那除了新任务，随着新地图、新剧情的开展，我们也为大家准备了和黑暗系列相关的群系列活动：群星沉眠之海区域探索活动和星海石影留影收集活动。
You got a photo event, so it could so they can make you explore the, you know, the new area.
同梦的终结，现实联机挑战活动。
Co-op, co-op battles. I'm a huge advocate for co-op. I'm gonna be excited for this one, bro. Holy shit.That's gonna be crazy.
那个全息挑战玩法进行了升级，让你可
You could do a hologram co-op. Oh my god! I was gonna make a video on how co-op will work in WooWa. Oh, that's real good. That's really fun. Too bad it's not to event. They need to do more of these. They need to do this event every patch. Then. Really good. Good shit. Good shit. Co-op. I love co-op.Me personally, I know most people prefer to play single player, but I love co-op. I like playing with the homies.
这些都将会跟随版本更新逐步开启。好啦，以上这些就是1.3版本将会和大家见面的游戏内容，希望大家会喜欢哦。
That's gonna be exciting.
大家喜欢。那另外也为大家送上这次临时通讯的特别奖励，第二个兑换码，请漂泊者们查收哦。其实今天的临时通讯。除了向各位漂泊者们预告游戏内容，我们也还想和大家再简单聊一下关于
That's really hype right there.
嗯，是的。
That's really fucking hype.
自明条上线以来，我们陆续收到漂泊者们反馈的各种问题，
也
切切实实的感受到
游戏中
存在的各项痛点。
They still need the game still do need a lot of improvement.
敏捷的根据大家集中的反馈和意见进行了调优迭代。截止当前，我们完成了大小数十次的更新修复。也顺利完成了上千个条目的优化迭代，例如我们锁定和镜头视角的优化、活跃度任务的优化、养成相关的调整等等。当然，我们深刻意识到优化一定是一个长期且不断的事情。在未来的版本，我们也会有更多的内容跟着版本继续更新迭代。而为了更加敏捷地改善游戏体验，我们会快速上线一些优化内容。但这一定不意味着这部分的优化内容已经结束了，例如性能优化、120帧的适配、手柄操控体验，以及我们玩法内容的补足等等。以上这些都是我们在未来会重点去开发跟优化的内容，我们一定不会懈怠，会尽快而且尽力地去解决大家提出的问题，更敏捷地解决大家的体验痛点。
All of this info that he's telling me is very reassuring. This let me know that they really do give a fuck about the game. You know what I'm saying? I like that shit. They still constantly trying to improve the game and heeding the community's calls. You know what I'm saying? Because the game is still always in need of improvement, man. That's awesome that they recognize that. I'm glad.
在地图中寻找目标，都将可以使用快捷前往功能。
I'm happy at how much they care about this game.
目标附近最近的可传送。
I really am.
给你传送到目标之后，给你自动追踪。以后跑任务时需要的多步操作就会更加简便了。
哇、wow, ，太棒了！
此外呢，我们对于开放世界当中分布比较集中的角色突破材料采集物，增加了负极区域追踪功能。漂泊者可以通过此项功能，
直接标记一块区域，
集中进行采集。
Because what I usually do is look at the interactive map.
哎，说到这个，我想到《守望人》的变身玩法在这里面应该会大有可发挥之地啊。
确实哦，使用守望人化身蝴蝶在大世界采集，那一定是爽歪歪了，
卡卡爽啊！另外，在版本更新之后，在地图界面，我们可以根据开放世界区域分类进行快速跳转。对于想要达成更高探索度的漂泊者们
，Okay, that's good. That's really good.
1.3 版本中，我们在原有的剧情跳过功能上新增了对应的剧情梗概。漂泊者们在选择跳过剧情时，可以通过简洁易懂的梗概内容快速了解跳过部分的剧情发展。
Okay, that's good, actually. That's really good.
漂泊者希望快速过剧情，但是又不希望错过关键信息。
That's actually really good right there.
同时啊，我们在万物图鉴中新增了世界观名词图鉴，将剧情进展至对应进度，即可将相关的名词收录。漂泊者可以随时查阅相关的内容，更轻松地了解关于索拉里斯的一切。
That's for the people that do care about the story and lore about that. That's really good. That's really fucking good.
在还未解锁的活动界面，点击问号处查看活动所需的全部解锁条件。如果是剧情进度类的限制条件，可以直接跳转剧情任务界面进行追踪。
另外
okay, so you can basically you can skip quests that's locked behind. You can skip to a quest that's locked behind a previous quest.
漂泊者在整理背包中的生骸时，可以将有用的生骸上锁，无用的生骸标为弃置。再结合优化后的筛选功能，就可以利用数据屋的数据融合功能，实现方便的整理背包啦。当然，数据屋的数据融合功能我们也一并进行了优化。以往只能单次放入生骸进行融合。
Oh, that's really good. That's really fucking good.
可以一次性放入生骸融合材料100个，
这是节约了很多时间的。
That's insane.
除了体验类的
makes data matching a lot faster.
界面美观度、辨识度相关的
really good, really good.
我们也有注意到，
比如呢？
比如之前版本在各类界面中选中所要使用的道具时，出于选中效果不够清楚，导致漂泊者使用了错误的道具。这样的反馈我们有收到过很多，因此我们优化了道具被选中后的效果显示，让它更加明显。还有比如之前的版本中
That's really good, because yeah, you couldn't really tell if you were like on top of something.
所以我们就对它进行了界面的迭代。现在的试用界面
Yeah, fixing the UI is really good. Overlays do need to work on the UI.
实际的优化内容还有很多。
That's really good.
更多的详情呢，就还请漂泊者们关注后续 1.3 行至海岸尽头版本内容说明了。
Making the UI a lot easier to read is like it's something that's every game that should be good at. You know what I'm saying?
一直以来的支持和提供的各类优化意见建议，谢谢大家对我们明朝项目组的支持。
是的，今天在这里，我们也是想跟所有的漂泊者保证，优化一定是我们项目组长期会进行的专项内容。我们会不断的优化各个平台的游玩体验。这件事情不管明朝进行到 2.0 还是 3.0 甚至更加后续的版本，它都不会改变。你们的反馈我们都有看到，也希望大家继续为我们提供各种优化建议，谢谢大家对我们的支持。
也还请大家继续关注明朝，关注官方账号的发布信息。
Arigato，
当然还是要以好东西收尾了。接下来就让我们送上本
次
通讯的最后一个兑换码吧。
那么以上就是本次临时通讯想向大家分享的游戏资讯了，非常感谢大家的收看，希望在即将到来的 1.3 版本我们能让大家拥有更好的游戏体验。重要的信息值得反复的强调，所以明朝 1.3 版本行至海岸尽头将于9月29日正式开启。
Nice， 呼哎，
今日的临时通讯内容就到此结束
了。 Nice at the end of September.
感谢各位漂泊者们的
收看。 It's really good, really good.
拜拜。
Hey, that music's catchy. Anything further right here? Let's see. Let me see. Oh, they showed the turtles dancing again. They really like that goddamn turtle. They love that damn turtle. They like that goddamn turtle so much.
Bye.
Alright, alright. Oh, they did show a bit more. Alright, let me see. Hey, I love this song. It's pretty fucking catchy. Let's see. Is that like a new figurine? Oh, okay. They working in progress. Cool. Anyways, this is my full thoughts on the live stream. You guys already know, bro. This live stream was such a good live stream, bro. I really love 1.3. It looked like we got a lot to look forward to. It's nice to know that they still like working on improvements of the games, and it's nice to see coming from the devs mouths themselves, the game designers themselves. They still trying to work on the improvement of the game, and they still want to make the game a lot better. And I like seeing it coming from their minds instead of just from a website. And it's nice to know. And it feels different that it's coming from them themselves on live stream. You know what I'm saying? I think it's really fucking good how much they care about the game and how much they care about the community. I think the Wolverine Ways does is really fucking really good at doing that shit. I'm very excited for 1.3, bro. Shorekeeper, I look forward to her. And you know, I see what she got cooking in terms of her story. Unfortunately, Shorekeeper, oh my god, she's gonna have to get skipped for Camellia, bro. Camellia is coming to patch after. She's gonna have to get skipped. I ain't gonna lie, bro. But what's interesting about 1.3 that they didn't mention, that probably no one has talked about, was that Shorekeeper is the only 5-star in 1.3, which is interesting. I wonder what they're doing. I think they're trying to like catch back up on the scheduling in terms of what they did with like Yin Lin. But then again, they did the whole thing for 7 weeks until 1.1 came out. You know what I'm saying? They had to take an extra week for that. But I don't know if it's like a scheduled thing. So I'm intrigued on what they might be cooking with that, because it's quite interesting that they didn't have 2 5-stars coming out for 1.3. They got 1 5-star and 1 4-star. And it seems to be the same for 1.4, because 1.4 has Camellia and Lumi, and they only show Camellia as the only 5-star, which is interesting. So I wonder what they might be cooking with that, because usually, at least this is how Yohoyo usually do it, really. They always release 2 5-stars in a patch, but they usually have 1 4-star on one of the banners. So they usually release, so sometimes they release 3 new characters in one patch, sometimes. Because 4-star, the thing about 4-star characters, with the way they are released, they kind of get released like every other patch, you know what I'm saying? Like, sometimes we're gonna have patches where we just don't have a 4-star character, which is fine. But you can't go too long without a new 4-star. You know what I'm saying? But it's every other patch. Why every single patch we have 2 5-star characters usually. So, and it seems the way they're doing it is quite different. And I wonder if they might be cooking with something. Or it just could be nothing at all. It could just be how they want to schedule the characters. You know what I'm saying? Or Camellia was originally, you know, meant to be for 1.3. But she probably ended up getting scrapped into going to delay into 1.4. Or she just intentionally been into 1.4. They just intentionally wanted to put one new 5-star. But anyways, yeah. That's pretty much all I want to talk about with that part of the live stream, in terms of what's interesting about that. Because it's something that they just haven't talked about, which is quite interesting. Quite interesting. 2, Yuhu. Yuhu seems to have some mechanics that they said on the website that might be interesting. And they seem to be testing out the waters in terms of that. Yuhu has quit time events in her kit. She has like quick time event whenever you ult with her. Like, you gotta press like a specific button, like some specific set of buttons before, like, within a specific amount of time. You know what I'm saying? And that's kind of how her little ult works from what I've seen with her ultimate. it seems to be quite interesting with that. I wonder if she's gonna be like a new healer or something. We haven't gotten a healer since like the launch of the game, literally, which is interesting. Maybe Lumi might be one, who knows? But Lumi looks more like a buffer than a healer, which is interesting. Because I've been wanting a new healer in the game, ain't gonna lie, because I've been in need of a new support character for my account. But anyways, yeah. And also, they added the event where you could play co-op with your homies, bro. I think that shit is fire, bro. Like, I can't wait to get on with my homie, because I have a homie that plays WooWa, bro, with me. You know what I'm saying? And yeah, I can't wait to hop on co-op and play the hologram co-op, bro. I've been advocating for that shit for a while, too. Because I've been wanting, like, co-op in the game. I've been wanting them to do more with the co-op in the game. And I'm glad that they're doing more with the co-op in the game. Especially with the hologram fights. Doing the hologram co-op is going to be really fun. Considering that the hologram is, like, the most fun mode in the game right now. I really think so. And doing it with the homies, bro, it's gonna feel like fighting the fucking raid boss, my guy. That shit's gonna be crazy, man. Especially if they're gonna be like as difficult as they are, you know what I'm saying? With two players, ooh, man. I wonder if his stats are gonna scale, you know what I'm saying? With like co-op, you know what I'm saying? So if you have three people, he has even more HP and shit. He has less HP than three people, you know? You know what I'm saying? When you play with two players and then with one HP, he has the usual amount with one person, of course. But, you know, let's see if what they have to offer with this update. And the quality of life things, such as making the data bank a lot faster, is really cool. Doing some things with the UI is a lot better, you know? You make it easier to see what you're selecting. You know what I'm saying? They did a good job with this live stream, bro. They did a good job with the presentation. And I look forward to the story of 1.3 and see what Shorekeeper has to offer in terms of her character. You see? Because, unfortunately, I'm going to skip her for Camellia. That's just how it is, man. You know what I'm saying? Camellia is a character that I've been highly anticipating for a long-ass time. And I look forward to 1.4 after this, bro. Because I think 1.4 probably might be another banger patch because Camellia is a very high anticipated character by many. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So that's enough for me yapping, bro. That's enough for that yap fest, bro, that I've been doing, bro. And tell me what your thoughts is in the comment section down below, bro. What you guys think of the live stream? Was it good? Was it bad, bro? What you think of it? Do you like Shorekeeper? Do you like the characters, bro? I think this shit was awesome, man. Really good. Keep that shit up, Wolverine Waves Devs. Anyways, you guys already know, bro. If you like the video. You can dislike the video. I don't give a fuck what you do, bro. Comment anything. Comment dot. Comment 69. Comment anything, bro. I don't give a fuck what you do, man. Bro. You already know, bro. Subscribe, bro. You already know, man. And yo, I appreciate you guys for watching. And see y'all. Oh yeah, and I forgot to mention one thing. We play many different types of games on the channel, bro. We play Mario games, we play gacha games, we play WooWa, bro. We play many different types of games, adventure, action, whatever, man. Man, I hope y'all still enjoy the variety of the games. We do reacts too, bro. We like talking about games. We do tier lists, you know, whatever the game, bro. You know what I'm saying? I hope you guys enjoy the video, bro. And see y'all later. Peace. Yeah!